Listen briefly. Now, after launching it in JDO, to increase the children to orbit so as to make the energy transition in the to moon, we will have to total 6 separate births of children to using its own propulsion system. On reaching the energy for the third time in JDO, the first one in the energy will raise the apogee altitude to about 47,000 km, and on reaching the fourth apogee, we will burn again to increase the energy to about 240 km. This 240 km energy will be held, and then in 4 different orbits on different dates, and in energies numbered 6, 11, 16, and 19 around the Earth, we will raise the apogee stepwise to 55,800, 71,500, 89,700, and finally 1,000 km. Then, on 14 hours, period of 2 hours, this will happen on the 1st of September 2019. Then, by this time, we will have consumed about 59 billion grams of fuel from the Chandrayaan. And the Chandrayaan mass, along with Vikram orbiter and Lander program, will be about 2350 kilograms in lunar orbit of 100 by 100. Subsequently, the lunar lander carrying the lunar rover Pragyan, the separate from the remaining 875 kilograms and then 2, and will be put in the lunar orbit of 30 km by 100 km in preparation of soft landing on Moon near its south pole. All the dates mentioned by me are in the Indian standard time and arrived by our calculations based on chosen landing site and the conditions required for the same. Finally, on 7 September at 2:58 a.m. Inter-standard time, the Vikram lander and the lunar rover Pragyan will soft land on Moon with a velocity of 2 meters per second, and after final checks, the 27 kg lunar rover Pragyan will be deployed on the surface. Pragyan will have a life of 14 Earth days, which is equal to 1 lunar day. Chandrayaan 2 has a mission life of 1 Earth year. All the three bodies, that is the Chandrayaan 2 orbiter, the Vikram lander, and the Pragyan rover, will conduct valuable scientific experiments in the service of our country and mankind.